Hello everyone, I hope you are all doing well. Welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I wanted to share with you how I currently do my dip nails at home. No, I will disclaim, I am not a professional in any way. I am not telling you that this is the way that you should do your nails. I'm here to tell you, if you're not very good at nails and you can't really go to a nail tech right now, you can still have decent looking nails at home that last you a while. These last me usually 2 to 3 weeks. 3 weeks, they're looking crazy because of the growth, but I do not have any lifting or anything of the sort. If you've been watching my videos and maybe forgot to subscribe, make sure to click the button and notification bell. I post videos every Thursday and I cover beauty, lifestyle, and DIY. So welcome to the community. If you want to learn how to get this hot pink dip manicure with the hollow accent nail, then keep watching. I'm gonna start off by showing you how I remove dip powder with an e-file. This can damage your natural nail, and I am still practicing to make sure that I don't do that. You do have to soak your nails in acetone for removal if you are not using the e-file. I have a cuticle pusher. Cuticle remover is very useful. It just makes things so much easier. This is just a bit set that actually came with the e-file. I did purchase this bit particularly for removal. You will need a buffing block and your files, some clippers, of course. This is a set that I got off of Amazon, kind of like a starter kit. You just get a hot pink, you get a silver, a French white, a French pink. This is my most used color. And then you get the clear along with all of these steps for the dip powder. Lastly, this is totally optional, a base and top coat, just gel polish, and then this Melody Light to cure that. This is extremely affordable, but again, gets the job done. I am starting with the bit that is for removal. This one's a little bit dull already because I have used it a few times. I have it set on low, and you don't want to linger on the nail. I'm actually not removing the full dip powder because I had no lifting on this hand. When I'm trying to remove dip powder from the edges of the nails, I just switch to this bit. This is just made for the natural nail. So I took off as much as I could. Now I'm just going to shape them. And I just normally do an oval shape. The prep is truly the most tedious part because the actual application of the powder doesn't really take that long. So now we are going to go in with the cuticle remover. Now taking the cuticle pusher, I'm just gonna push them back. And I've already butchered one of my cuticles. That's a great start. So this is a good example of when you're pushing them back and you do have a lot of excess, you can use one of these. See, it just comes right off. You can also just take your clippers, trim them. You don't have to remove them fully. You just don't want the excess hanging out. Okay guys, switching to voiceover because my kids are awake. You will be hearing children in the background. I'm using a nail dehydrator. The one in the kit evaporated, so I had to purchase a separate one. I'm applying it only on the natural nail area. On to step two, we're gonna be creating a fake apex because my nails are very thin and bendy right now. So I'm painting a line in the middle of the nail. Make sure you don't reach the cuticle with this. And then I'm dipping into clear powder. I do this twice just to build up that little bit of a bump. It's going to help strengthen the nail so that if you bump into things, you're less likely to break your nail. I'm using an old makeup brush to dust off excess powder. So now we're moving into the bright pink. I'm using step three, which is meant for layering, and I'm painting my nails as I normally would, and then dipping into the color. Very important that you dust off the excess so that your nails are not bumpy. A quick tip, if you're not very good at painting your nails, just make sure to clean off the edges, cuticle area, and then dip into the powder. That way you won't have the dip powder clinging onto the cuticle, and it's less likely to create lifting. Back to steps two and four, we're going to do a layer all over the nail and dip into the clear powder. This is going to seal in that color. Dust off the excess, very important. And then moving on to step five, the gel activator. This is going to harden the dip powder in itself. Once that's done, go ahead and take your files and buff to shape them. Make sure they're not too lumpy. I like using the e-file because it really helps correct any type of mistakes that were made around the cuticle area. And I'm just using the bits that came with the kit. I really like this particular bit. It's thin, you can get underneath the nail. So if you have any dip powder clinging onto the skin, this will help clean it right up. Now that we got our color all set, we're gonna move into the gel polish. I'm gonna set up the hollow powder on the side before you cure anything. I'm starting off with a base coat on the accent nail, and I'm only curing this for 10 seconds. You need this to be slightly tacky for the hollow powder to adhere. And then you just brush it on with an applicator or even your fingers. You wanna make sure you don't pick up too much color because then it'll just look silver instead of holographic. I really love this hollow powder because it will always look different depending on the base color underneath. Now I'm taking a little bit of acetone on a Q-tip and I'm just cleaning up those edges before I do my final top coat. My curing lamp is a little small, so I do my thumbs first and then I just do the rest of my fingers. I like to cure it twice to make sure that everything is all set to go. And here are the finished nails. I think it looks pretty good for an at-home manicure. A lengthy process, a little tedious, but pretty easy and straightforward to do. Well worth it because these last about 2 to 3 weeks and you're saving yourself some money. That is it for today's video. Thanks so much for sticking around. I hope you enjoyed, found it helpful, and that you learned something new. If you liked it, make sure to share, and please feel free to leave your feedback down below, but be kind and gentle. I know I'm not very good at nails, but I truly just wanted to help you guys out. If you feel intimidated by doing your own nails, or you've never been good at it like I have, you can still get a decent looking manicure at home, and it was pretty easy to do. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.